good. How are you?
Great.
Are you doing it on video? Can I see you or no?
No, you can't see me, but actually I see you. There you are. I want to show you my charts. Let's see if this works to show you my charts here.
Okay.
Hold on.
I see them.
Okay, good. Anyways, you've been doing really great, so I thought I would do just like a little video with you because you've been doing so well. In fact, I forget, when exactly did you do the class?
Oh, did we do it in September? And then I repeated it. I know I went live October 1st, so I'm thinking it was September 15th I did the course with my husband. And then what I did was I repeated it the next week because I did like the paper trade, and I was in the class, I was watching, and then kind of what you said, the first class then made even more sense when I watched it the second time.
Yeah, that's good. That's why I let people do the retakes. Yep. So that's positive. So then, so you've just been doing well. I mean, I just think it's just so great that you've been doing so well so fast, and because some people don't listen to me. And it's so great because you do. And I don't know if it's because you're a woman or what, because, you know.
Well, I think number one, from what I've been listening, those other guys have taken a zillion courses. And I think what they try and do is they try and pull like something from every course they took and make it like some sort of hybrid thing. And I don't think it works like that.
Yeah.
Like I've just taken your course. That's it.
Now, how did you find me again?
Well, my husband found you because this is like he's a doctor, but he loves to trade, and we were watching ACE trades for a while. And his idea was, you stay home, you trade, and I'll go out and like be the doctor. I'm like, I don't even know what you're talking about, you know. So then he found you, and then he goes, oh, this will work. Like this is like, because I told him, I said, I have a busy day, I want to get in and out, and that's just what you are. Like, you know, 95 to 97% of the time, we're in, we're out, and we're gone.
Yeah.
And I like that a lot.
And you, for you, get up early. You do it early because you're ahead of the time.
I hold my whole schedule around Stock Swoosh.
That is so great. I'm so happy.
I'm having a lot of fun. I get all excited. I like about the tickers, and I'm like, ooh, I wonder how this did today. I'm a nurse. So I'm a nurse by trade, but I left my one job and I want to leave my one at the end of the year. I already gave them notice.
Wow, that's terrific. Yeah. So so instead of having one full-time job before, you had two part-time jobs.
Yeah. So what I would do is like, I would work, I work half a day on Tuesday, but I work Tuesday afternoon so I can do this Tuesday morning. Mm-hmm. My only stick point is Fridays, that I work Friday all day. Now he's off this Friday, so I'll be in the room tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And so I gave them notice, and I said, you know, in a year's time, I kind of gave them enough notice to like look around, because I don't want to stick the doctor, he's too good to me. So
Well, that's I know, that's fantastic. So what would you like, what advice could you give to people that are new? Because I do have a lot of people that email me, they never did this before, they're scared, you know, and stuff like that.
Well, I think just taking the course twice, I think taking it once and then doing a week or two of paper trading and like getting used to hitting the buttons. And when you told me to set up the hotkeys, but every time I take, like every time I'm in the room with you, like yesterday. So when I went into UA, I took $600 or 600 shares. And then you said to add, it was like 5 minutes. So I added 1,000 because it was so low.
Yeah.
So I had 1,600 shares, but probably if I back, because you told us we were going to be in it all day, if I backed off a little and say only took another 400 shares, and then when you gave us the clue to add again, because that's, I think, when I saw the chart, because that 1957, and then it tanked a whole dollar.
Yeah.
And then that's when I would have really made money. But I did mitigate my loss, which is okay.
Yeah.
So I just listen to you. I just do what you say.
Yeah. So you don't find that hard to do. I mean, I think I'm easy to follow because I'm only looking at one or two things. But, you know, I mean, some people, I guess maybe that was, I think you made a good point there, which is interesting about the hybrid, that maybe people are trying to just take everything together and lump it all in or something.
Yep. They have all this background, and I didn't bring any of that to this. So I was like a clean slate. And I, So I think that even the guy that's going to retake the class next week, I think if he just comes, just throw everything out that he heard before. Because, and then maybe just concentrate on the, like sometimes I say to Ben, the options, maybe I should, but I'm going to at least just concentrate on shorts for a whole year.
Yes.
But you know what? If I'm making a good money doing this, then I'll stay, like, who needs the options, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that's what I say to people. You really only need one thing. It's like you only need one good trade a day. Yeah. That's really all that you need. Now, have we ever gone long since you've been in the room or not?
You know what? We went long with Apple. That one time,
I remember, I think it was back
in October, and you said, be in it all day.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I remember that one. Did you do it? Did you do that one or not?
I did it.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
And I did well. And then I think once with Gyro, we went long, and I did well with that. I think, but that was a quick one, too. That we went long, and it was like 20 minutes.
Uh-huh.
So, and that was only two times I went long. But so, I listened, you know.
Yeah. So, what time do you get in the room? Like, a half an hour before? Like, I haven't noticed. When do you sign in? Like, when do you start getting ready?
I'm usually here by, like, 8:57, 9 o'clock. That's mm-hmm. when I'm usually in the room. But I already, like, the night before, I do my research on the earnings.
Mm-hmm.
And then what I do sometimes at night is I go to see what it closed at. Mm-hmm. And then if it's gapping up or down, like last night. That's why I knew CN last night. I didn't think we were going to do it unless something crazy happened because it was gapping up.
Yeah. Yeah, and it wasn't a good one.
I take what you said. I always go through my notes.
Okay.
You know, and a whole about the market. If you like when the market's strong, because then if a stock's falling, it's still falling on our own. But there's sometimes we're in a short where if the market's come down, it'll pull it right down
with
it.
That's right. So. And then it makes it go even more, which is, I think, part of the reason UA also worked good then yesterday, too, because the market was falling as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, yesterday. So when you are, like, getting ready, do you look at what I have in the room, or do you rate the gaps, too, or you just go by my rating in the room? Like, what's the most benefit you think of being in the room? Do you double-check it, or you just, like, say, well, I'm just going to go with whatever she says, or?
Well, I don't go off on my own. I just think I'm too new. Like, okay. I would never do that. But I think, like, when you ask for suggestions, like, I saw OXM. So that was also gapping down, but if you saw what it did, I mean, I didn't really rate that, but you didn't like it, and
oh, God, look at it, yeah.
Yeah, but if you look back at the dailies, like, it looks, and then that was earnings, so I thought, okay, we're gapping down, so that's another good one. So why that one didn't work, it didn't, but you wouldn't have gone in anyway until the second, you know, until it's set up,
yeah. So you have, like, I mean, you just got right into the thing about taking the trades, like, quick.
Yeah.
Like, you just immediately had no issue with just getting in, getting out. Because, I mean, I think that's the fun thing about doing it, too, to just get in and out quickly.
Yeah.
And some people aren't used to that. Most day traders wait till after 10 o'clock to even do anything. And for me, I like the fast ones.
Yeah, I just noticed, and I don't know if you'll agree, but... So when we do it fast, mm-hmm. it seems like we make our money, but if we're in it long, it's like it goes up, it goes. It's like, wait, well, I always say it's like watching ice melt.
Yeah.
So I always think that if you get that first drop, and sometimes I was with you that one week where we waited to try until it pushed down, and then we were like, oh, here we are all day.
Yeah, I know. Well, I personally would rather, like, this is even still going here. It's 10:45. This is probably going to get to 14, this TLRD. But but you still don't know exactly.
I know. That's like yesterday with UA. It hit 18:40, and I kept saying to myself, this is it. It's going to drop to 18, and then I didn't get out, and I'm like, ah, man.
But I mean, I did feel like 18:50 was reasonable, except for it took all afternoon. So in the morning, it did not go there, but then it did later in the day. And then again, that's the thing. Sometimes you can see something's going to go to a point. Here, this is at 18 right now. See, so you did read that, right? It's at 18 right now. It's falling today. It gapped down this morning. I mean, we could have done this.
Yeah, I was looking at it this morning. I'm going, oh, I wonder if she'll do a continuation gap on this one.
Well, so now, did your husband ever do any classes before you guys did mine or not?
Oh, yeah, he's done tons. I think he's a frustrated trader. He does your options, but, you know, he gets a gazillion newsletters, almost as much as medical journals.
Oh, my God, that's hilarious.
But he's timid. Like, I'm just like I would do what you say, like, the conviction I had.
Yeah.
And he's like, well, you know, you can get out of half of it, or you can make your 1,000 and not do the rest of the week. I'm like, no. I look at every day like it's a new day. I don't say, okay, I made 1,000 Tuesday. I'm done. I'm walking away.
Uh-huh.
Even if I could make 200, like, that's just, you know, little by little. So yeah. I look at every day as a new day, and I'm not going to trade just because I hit my mark.
Oh, that's great. Well, that's how you're going to make progress, too. Plus, you learn every day because, I mean, every day is a new thing. Like, even, like, the one last week, was it last week, the big? That one, when that went up, and did you stay with that one and you kept the stop? Were you in the, no, you weren't. You weren't in the room that day. You were off.
That's right. I was in Mexico.
That's right. Oh, shoot. No, because that one really pushed back hard, and some people didn't leave the stop in, and they killed it. Here, this is what you missed. This was not easy. You probably would have followed me, though, because you've been doing such a good job with that. But, yeah, you were away. You were away. Yeah. That's right. So this pushed back, went over the high. It held the stop that I said, but some people just got out of it because then killed it. Here, because of the fact that it did lift. But actually, we had the stop very far away, and it held through. So we got in it here. Then it pushed back. People killed it. But we had to stop all the way up here. But then it went.
Okay.
Yeah, you didn't do that one. That's right.
No, you know what? I trust your stops. I mean, you look at everything. You look at it far back. And so you know, and even sometimes, like, you stopped out, and I'm like, should we have stopped out? Yeah. But, you know, every day I just learn. And so every day I'm a teens better. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, and, you know, I would never, you know... But those people get you so mad. It's so. And I always say I'm the mother of seven, but you sound like you're talking to kids sometimes.
Well, I want everyone to do well, and I think that's why, you know, you've been such a great success story, and why I wanted to do the video with you, because it makes me feel good to see people do well, and I want everyone to do well. When people don't listen to me or don't put the stops in or do other trades or use other systems and try to incorporate with mine. You know, again, this is all that I've ever done, but I mean, I definitely know this works, and people don't need anything else. And so I wish that people would stay focused. And it really is very important to stay focused. And sometimes when you're looking at something like the one you were talking about this morning, or this, like, it is that intuition that I have because I only do this and I've been doing it for so long that helps me. And if you're all over the board, then you're never going to get that intuition either. So you're in a good place because you are just focused on the gaps, and you don't have any, you don't have any baggage, you know, from doing other things or learning stuff that didn't work.
And I'm just trying not to overwhelm myself. Like, even like, you know, there's a part of me that wants to take the trends class and wants to take the, and I'm like, and I'm a better learner if I just master what's in front of me, and then I go on. Like,
yeah,
when I'm
you're
ready.
Doing good. Yeah, I mean, you're doing great. I think it's fantastic that you already set your goal for next year, that you're going to be completely focused on this, and that you're able to quit your other part-time job. I mean, that's great too. I mean, obviously, I can't imagine having seven children. So you have time to do anything at all.
That makes me focused, and that actually makes me structure my day better, and maybe that helps me with something like this, you know, the whole thing. And being a nurse, nurses are very task-oriented.
Yeah.
You know, today, and even my workout's important to me. I'm 57 years old. I work out four times a week, and I'm going to hit my 1,000th workout class.
Wow. When you said that yesterday, that the tray was interfering with your exercise schedule, I laughed to myself, because I feel like that some days, too. I try to get it in the morning, but if I oversleep, then I'm screwed, because you never know, number one, if I'm going to get it in later, and also sometimes you're tired. The later the day goes on, the more tired that you are, and I don't even have seven kids.
Well, I did get it in at 4 p.m., so I was good.
That's good. You know what? Structure is important. It is. It's important with training. And that's why I like, you know, I'm a morning person. So it works good for me living in Eastern time zone. And I do like the structure. That's why, like, I like to know before the open, are we going to do anything today? Are we not going to do anything today? Is this one what we're watching? And I like structure. I'm a structure person. And so it sounds like you are too.
Yeah, I think I definitely.
I mean, if you're doing surgeries, then it's a similar thing. Like, I do the checklist. Like, before you go into surgery, you have to do this thing, this thing, this thing. Everything has to be checked off before you cut the person open. I mean, so it's a similar idea as far as he's planning on trading once he retires, or what is he, you know?
Yes. Oh, yes. He would love to. Yes. Mm-hmm. You know, and of course, I tell him all about my day, and I show him your charts, and I show him the YouTube videos, so he's living vicariously through me.
Oh, that's cute.
Yeah.
That is so cute. Well, I'm really proud of you, Jackie. Just keep up the good work. And, you know, anytime you want to talk to me or reach out or have questions, but you're pretty good at asking questions in the room when you have a question.
Yeah, I'm not shy.
Yeah.
And I like everybody. everybody. Like, even Gyro, you know, when he takes over for you, he's, you know, he's a good guy and stuff.
He's a good guy. He's a different personality, but he, you know, it's interesting because he somehow found me through the internet and then ended up doing my class, and he had just been doing swing trading. So he was doing swing trading, then found me, and then years after he was a student, he came to New York to meet me. And then we got to be friends, and then when I needed help, you know, then he offered to help. But he knows what he's doing.
He definitely does.
But he's more doing a lot of the swing trades and stuff like holding. Okay. So he's focused more on that. But he's definitely a good guy. Yeah, definitely like him a lot.
Well, I'm originally from New Jersey. I've only been in Buffalo since 2013. So I was born and raised in Elizabeth, which is on the other side of the Gotham's Bridge. And then I raised my family in Toms River. So I'm really a beach girl. But,
oh, wow. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, but Ben's job is up here. So that's how we wound up in Buffalo. We got married in 2013. Uh-huh. So, well, yeah. And he just took me with the 7 kids. So that tells you what kind of guy he is. See, there's hope for you too, Melissa.
I know there is. I'm staying positive. Of course, I got to make time to actually date instead of work so much. You know.
I know. That's the thing.
That is the thing.
It's all about the balance.
Have you ever caught me on TV?
Oh, yeah. I watch it like on Charles and stuff like that. Yeah.
Oh, that's cute. Easy. Yeah.
Well, and Ben almost thought, oh, she might want to Skype you. Maybe she wants to do a TV segment with you. She wants to do a TV thing with me, I need a glam squad.
Yeah, I would definitely have given you a warning for that. Well, it's fun. I am so proud of you, Jackie. You're doing great. So congratulations. If I don't talk to you before the holidays.
It's been so much fun. I enjoy being in the room every day. I really do.
Oh, I enjoy having you. I love hearing people that are doing well. I love it. And I'm trying to work with the people that, you know, like the other gentleman you mentioned. And I'll have to bring up the point because I think they are trying to mush everything together. And maybe that's what people are struggling with, but I honestly feel like sometimes people that have no background do better, just like you.
That's right.
Even though you might have a learning curve.
No preconceived notions.
Yes,
none.
Exactly.
So we're a clean slate. We're easier for you to teach us.
That's right. Yep. A clean slate. Yep. Well, I'm proud of you.
Melissa, thank you so much.
Thank you. Tell Ben I said hi.
Okay, I will.
All right. Bye. Have a happy holiday.
Okay, you too.
Okay, bye-bye.